I'm not that pressure for 60 minutes, baby. They can't stop us.
It's not about what you're capable of. It's about what you're willing to do. We're a band of brothers. We're the Steelers. Steelers on three. One, two, three. Feet
into the end zone for a touchdown. And it's a diving catch. Unbelievable.
No team has won more Super Bowls than the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Here is Bradshaw rolling right. Bradshaw gets a big block and fires into the end zone, complete for the touchdown. Getting married ball in the end zone.
Contribution.
When Bill Cowher stepped down 1 year after title number five, the Steelers found who would lead them to title number six.
I'm very pleased to introduce the next coach of the Pittsburgh Steelers, Mike Tomlin.
It's a great honor to be a part of one of the most storied franchises in all of professional sports. We're coming to grips with what that means, but we're having fun. We intend to make no bold predictions about what we're going to do. What we are going to do is promise to have a first-class blue-collar work ethic and how we approach our business.
In his first training camp, Coach Mike Tomlin began shaping his team.
All right, man. Thriving or surviving, right? All right, hit that horn, babe. Let's dance.
I want to see how miserable we can get today.
Yeah.
And who enjoys it?
You dragging today, man. You stayed up too late last night. 81, don't let me catch you smiling today like you're actually having a good time. Little pass under pressure. Here we go. Which way are we going?
Going right here to the road.
I like it. I like it. Oh! You look like a damn Ninja Turtle. Do your thing.
In his second season, Tomlin kept his enthusiasm.
You look like a poster of an NFL corner, huh? Get your game on. Your guns look a little bit better this year. Just a little bit.
Bud raised his expectations.
I want you to have the best of your
first
life
again,
this year.
Pittsburgh ball.
Can you do that for me? That's the only way we're going to be world champs, man. Really? Hey, you know what I like about you this year? You don't appear to just be glad to be here this year. It's a little different from my perspective. I like that. Go get it.
Like Nate Washington, no one wearing black and gold was just happy to be there in 2008. As they began the toughest schedule in the NFL, the Steelers had their sights set on a title. Willie Parker set his on the end zone.
And we have a Pittsburgh Steelers touchdown.
Goes to the draw handoff, and Willie Parker finds a crack. He's at the five, spins into the end zone for a touchdown off the left side.
Parker rushed for a career-high three touchdowns. The Steelers built an early 21-0 lead and then zeroed in on Houston quarterback Matt Shaw. Pittsburgh opened one of the greatest defensive seasons in history with 5 sacks and 3 turnovers.
He throws the pass, and it's intercepted. Steelers have it.
The Steelers' dominance extended to Ben Roethlisberger, who completed 13 of his 14 passes.
Throws it for the O-line. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Throws for the goal line. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. That's Hines Ward. The Steelers are having fun at Heinz Field, and these guys from Texas just don't know what's hit them.
In week 2, Mother Nature did her best James Harrison impression. Neither would let up.
Say it hot.
Hey, what you want to do?
Don't do that.
92 is bringing it every time.
Harrison and the Steelers' defense held the Browns out of the end zone and limited them to 53 yards rushing. As the weather got worse, Pittsburgh got better.
Wow. It's coming down now.
So much for no rain, huh?
Play action fake. He wants to throw it. He's airing it out down the right side of the field. The pass will be intercepted. Bryant McFadden. Ben on 3rd and 9 of the 11 in the shotgun. Ben throws for the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. The dog pound is whimpering.
That's what I'm talking about right there. That's a great drive right there on you guys. That's good job, Ellie. Good protection. Right when I saw the ball right here, the wind just took off, and it went from here to here.
The Steelers left Cleveland with their 10th straight win over the Browns.
Woo! Steeler Nation, what's up, baby? What's up, baby?
The Battle of the Keystone State provided a reality check for Ben Roethlisberger and the Steelers' offensive line.
Ready? You got me? You got me?
All right, let's go.
Black 20. Black 20.
He is getting hit at every opportunity. Roethlisberger is hit. They sack him again.
The Eagles are coming with some serious, serious pressure.
He doesn't know what happened. You know, he doesn't know what to do, which way to turn, because everywhere he turns, there's a white jersey there in his face.
The blitzes that these guys have been bringing in, it has made Ben step up in the pocket.
The ball is stripped. The Eagles seem to have it.
Wow.
We just got to keep blocking them long. They're not busting assignments.
Excuse me. Everybody look at me, okay? Get your damn head up. Look at the man. Let's talk. Let's communicate. Let's be mentally tough. All we need is a damn play, all right?
But on this day, it was Philadelphia that made the winning plays.
Turning the corner, getting the first down and more. Leaping, diving for a touchdown is Karell Buckholder.
The Steelers finished the game with 3 less points than the Eagles had sacks. There was no time for licking wounds with the 2-0 Baltimore Ravens visiting Heinz Field. Pittsburgh welcomed Joe Flacco to the rivalry the best way it knew how. But the rookie quarterback remained poised.
Flacco throws for the back of the end zone. It's a touchdown, Baltimore.
Trailing 13-3 in the third quarter, the Steelers' offense came to life.
The pass is caught at the 20, 15-10. Santonio Holmes is into the end zone. Touchdown.
He gets on a slant route across the middle. McAllister coming from the other side gets a shot, but he doesn't bring him down. He makes Ed Reed miss, and he scampers in the end zone.
While the pressure of one of the AFC's best rivalries didn't appear to faze Flacco, the pressure of the AFC's best pass rush did.
The ball is loose. The Steelers pick it up. Lamar Woodley scores a defensive touchdown, and this place is on fire.
After 2 touchdowns in 23 seconds gave them a 17-13 lead, the Steelers kept attacking.
Wide open at the 30. There goes Hines Ward at the 15, and he slips
Ward's catch led to a field goal, but Baltimore's LaRon McClain tied the game at 20, sending it into overtime.
He runs right over Lawrence Timmons.
In OT, with three running backs out with injuries, the Steelers needed a little more.
Ward's loose. He's at the 40. He's still on his feet at the 35. Dancing to the 31-yard line for Weldy Moore.
Moore's scamper set up Jeff Reed from 46 yards away.
Reed's kick is on its way. That kick is up. And that kick is good.
What a game.
Great game.
What a game.
The Steelers were now in first place and would remain there for the rest of the season.
Let me tell y'all something. Jacksonville Jaguar, Pittsburgh Steelers, prime time. You looking at it. Let's go.
This hard-hitting matchup had produced four straight Jacksonville wins. Early on, it looked like a fifth might be on the way.
Man is hit as he throws the pass. It's intercepted. The receiver never saw it. That was Santonio Holmes. Here comes Rasheed Matthews up the sideline. Only one man to beat with blockers. He gets to the 10, the 5. He's into the end zone for the Jacksonville Jaguar touchdown.
Santonio Holmes, the wide receiver, fell down in the route. Holmes never even saw the ball. The only receiver that was there was Mathis.
They mentioned Mathis up on you. Take that as a challenge. I want you to go to work all night tonight. All right, let's go.
When we get a chance, we be aggressive. Aggressive as hell. That's what we do here.
The Steelers persevered with the pass, throwing for 239 yards before halftime.
Keith Miller gets his first touchdown reception of the year. Touchdown reception of the season from 48 yards out.
What'd you have,
fight, man?
In the fourth quarter, the Jaguars fought back.
Fires a strike to Mercedes Lewis for the touchdown. Now they lead it 21-20, and the burden swings back to the Steelers' offense.
Every season provides defining moments in which a team must steel itself and prove its fortitude. The closing minutes presented Pittsburgh's first such championship test.
Here comes Moreldy Moore around the corner, still on his feet, first down. Cuts it back at the 40, bounced around at the 35, and tackled at the Jacksonville 32-yard line. Steelers trailing by one. He gets the snap. He's back. Blitz. He's going to be throwing the football. It's caught at the 15.
86 to deliver. Let's go. Everybody be cool.
With a minute 53 left, Ward did just that.
Ben is going to throw it. He throws it now. A little timing pattern. It's caught for a touchdown. Hines Ward got a step on the defender and pulled it in.
Boy, do you talk about being aggressive. Great call, great execution.
The AFC North leaders headed to their bye week with a 4-1 record. The Steelers' pass rush set the tone in their matchup with the winless Bengals. Pittsburgh piled up 7 sacks, and the hits kept coming even on offense.
Did you see Hines Ward knocked out Keith Rivers, their first-round draft pick from Southern Cal? Hines just de-cleats Rivers. Oh, my goodness.
For the first time all season, Roethlisberger was not sacked.
He's going to throw it long. There's a man open. His pass will be touchdown. That is Nate Washington.
And you know, when you got a receiver like Nate Washington, he can flat out fly. You lay it out there and let him go run under it.
Weldy Moore continued his outstanding work as a stand-in for Willie Parker.
touchdown Pittsburgh, but well, they more.
Moore scored three touchdowns and rushed for over 100 yards for the first time in a Pittsburgh uniform.
Well, he breaks it on the left side. He's at the 10, the 5, into the end zone for the touchdown. But well, Moore with 119 yards rushing, and the Steelers have put this one away in Cincinnati.
In Week 8, the Steelers hosted the defending Super Bowl champion New York Giants. Moore picked up where he left off in Cincinnati.
Moore finds it open. He's at the 15. Still on his feet at the 10. And he ducks out of a tackle into the end zone for a 32-yard scoring shot.
In the third quarter, the Steelers' big play offense struck again.
He's going to air it out down the field. He's got Nate Washington. Takes it at the 24.
Catches it right about the 22-yard line and puts a move on Butler, and he runs it for the touchdown. That was huge.
Now caught it. He turned around and said, I said, I got action.
Steelers receivers didn't receive as much action as they would have liked, thanks to four interceptions.
I just heard they snapper is out. James Harrison, they backup snapper. Let's make them put that ball down here.
With Pittsburgh leading by two, Harrison made one of his only mistakes of the season.
It goes over the end line for a safety, and that ties the game up at 14.
Boy, that one almost ended up in the Ohio River.
6 minutes left. 6 minutes left.
Too much time, as it turned out.
Manning back to throw. Here looks left. He's got Boss open. Touchdown, Giants.
The Steelers fell to 5-2 with another tough test ahead. The 6-2 Redskins.
Monday night, baby. Bright lights. Time to shine.
Steelers' front seven totaled seven sacks and helped to end an impressive streak by Campbell.
Throwing it underneath, tipped and intercepted. Steelers have it, and the streak is broken. 272 for Jason Campbell completed with that interception.
Campbell's next streak didn't last nearly as long.
And he dumps it off, picked off. Ty Carter with the pick, his first of the season.
Byron Leftwich replaced an injured Ben Roethlisberger and took command of the Pittsburgh offense.
We'll be 5 yards behind you, man. 5 to 6 yards in the box. I'm not going nowhere, but right there. Go to Nate. Go to Nate.
He throws it long down the field. There's a man open. And that is Nate Washington. Pulls it in to Santonio Holmes. Dive for the pylon. Touchdown, Pittsburgh!
You guys are 6-3, baby! We done came here and took one! We done came here and took one!
The Steelers began their brutal second half schedule against Peyton Manning and the Colts. The game had its share of unusual plays.
Peyton Manning throws it long down the field. The pass will be tipped and caught. Tipped by the Steelers and caught by Reggie Wayne, and he's gone for a touchdown. Play action fake. Now they go flea flicker. Ben stumbles around, throws it down the field. There's a man open, and it's caught inside the 15. We're winning it back to the middle of the field, down to the 2-yard line.
With the Steelers ahead by three, two surprising events led to their demise. First, Roethlisberger threw a late interception. Then the Steelers' defense left Dominic Rhodes wide open for the winning score. The loss dropped the Steelers to 6-3. The Steelers tried to recapture their rhythm the following week against the San Diego Chargers. Troy Polamalu showed his timing and agility is unparalleled.
Pass to Juggle and incomplete.
No, Troy got it.
Intercepted.
Let's see if it's a pick. Unbelievable. What a catch.
Wow. What a catch.
He kept his hand underneath it.
Yeah, it was a thing of beauty. He's probably the only safety in the National Football League that can get to that ball and catch it with one hand. What a great, great catch.
James Harrison, on his way to Defensive Player of the Year honors, intercepted a pass and scored a safety.
He's going to be hit. The ball's loose, picked up by San Diego. We've got a safety.
With just over 6 minutes left, the Steelers trailed 10-8 and were backed up at their own 13. Led by Roethlisberger and Ward, the Steelers drove 73 yards in 13 plays.
Man, scampers left out of the pocket. Waits, fires at the passes. Pulled in! What a catch by Hines Ward!
Ward's third down catch helped set up Jeff Reed for a 32-yard field goal.
The ball is down. The kick is on its way. That kick by Reed is up. That kick is good. And the Steelers leapfrog back in front with 11 seconds to go.
Enough time for the Chargers to try something desperate.
He dumps it off underneath. And they go with the lateral and the lateral again. And it's almost intercepted and broken up by Troy Polamalu. He's running with the football. And that's going to be a touchdown.
Officials mistakenly nullified the score, but the victory counted, and the Steelers moved to 7-3. In Week 12, the Steelers squared off against the only opponent in a 9-game stretch to finish with a losing record. And it was no contest.
Ben turns, gives to the second man. Here comes Gary Russell, uncut for the Pittsburgh Steelers touchdown. Looks right, nothing there. Now he wants to run it. He gets down to the five. He's down to the goal line. Touchdown, Ben.
Week 13, heavy rain. Two AFC heavyweights. And a likely playoff berth at stake. One team dropped the ball. The other took it away.
Kickoff to Slater. Oh! Muffs it. Oh, he kicks it. And he's running for it. And there's a pile up, and the Steelers appear to have it. They do.
The Steelers' passing game took advantage of the Patriot corners.
Ben back to pass. He pops. He fires for the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh!
Wear that right corner out, dog. Wear the right corner out all night.
Wants to throw it. Throws it very quickly. And that's going to be a touchdown.
You got a key to that guard. If that guard blocks down, it's a run. If he sets up, it's a pass.
James Harrison got the best of Patriot tackle Matt Light.
He's going to be hit, fumble. Who's going to get it at the 26? There's a big pileup. Pittsburgh has the football. New England is in the process of self-destructing.
He's trying to get him in that deep. He's going to show up fast and be late. Let's go.
everyone contributing to the dominant defensive performance. Pittsburgh recorded 5 takeaways, scored 30 unanswered points, and Lawrence Timmons came within a few inches of a 90-yard interception return for a touchdown.
One man to beat, and that is going to be a block by the Steelers. Timmons, 15-10, Timmons 5, Timmons to the goal line, and that will be...
He ran out of gas.
That's right!
They don't like us having this much fun
in
their ballpark.
I don't think so. It's not only a big win, but it's an old-fashioned butt-whooping.
The Steelers return home the following week to face another longtime nemesis.
Yeah, it's all about us. Hey, let's go, baby. We the only show.
The defense immediately made its presence felt.
Romo's back with time. He throws it down the field. Intercepted. Polamalu picks him off. And the Steelers play takeaway on the game's first series.
Pose the will on this crew. Pose the will on them.
In the first half, the Steelers forced 4 turnovers. Into the second half, the Cowboys scored the game's first touchdown.
Romo looking left, now middle, now pumps, now scrambling, now reverses field right, stops, points, Cox, throws it in the end zone, touchdown!
Yeah, baby, I love it! I got to put on for my city!
Save that energy. We need you. We got a whole half. Save it.
After Tony Romo's scramble in the pocket, Roethlisberger displayed some nifty footwork of his own.
Now they're going to miss him again, and he throws the ball to the near sideline. They say no.
What a play. It's
oh,
a catch.
Yes, it's a catch.
But the Steelers could not step across the Cowboys' goal line.
Hand off. He hit behind the line. Goal line stand. Brady James. The Cowboys still lead by 10.
Hey, let's go. Be cool. We cool. Let's go.
After closing to within 13-6, the Steelers got the ball back with 5 minutes to play.
Ben is back. One to throw the out. Now he throws a slant, running with it. Nate Washington, first down inside the Dallas 35.
Still
and he's tackled at the 32-yard line. Fires it. Got a man at the 5, and that is Nate Washington. Here's the blitz. He throws the quick out. Here comes Heath Miller. He's got a touchdown.
Heath runs that quick out, and he took Hamlin into the end zone. That's what you call not being denied.
And we've got a brand new ball game, folks.
Let's go, D. Put it in the end zone, baby. You know what time it is.
We're the best in the world, though. We're the best in the world, though.
Two plays after the offense tied the game, the defense tried to win it.
He's back. He waits. He looks. He fires the interception. Gives him the 25. The Shea Thompson to the 10, to the 5. He dives for the goal line. Pittsburgh touchdown. The Shea Thompson.
And boy, you talk about putting a dagger in the heart of the Cowboys.
And now comeback. Wow.
Man, what a beautiful game. And I mean that. I just told the team that, you know, people get too preoccupied with style points. That was a beautiful football game because we displayed metal.
Metal. The Steelers would need all they could muster in their battle with the Baltimore Ravens. with first place in the AFC North at stake. The game quickly transformed into a defensive slugfest, with the Ravens landing the early blows. Steelers stood their ground and positioned themselves for a late flurry.
Starts here, baby. Starts here. Let's go. Let's go.
With 3:36 left, the Steelers trailed by three and stood 92 yards from the Ravens' goal line. The stage was set for another great Steeler comeback.
And a great catch by Hines Ward.
Go entertain them, offense. Go entertain them. That's what we do, baby. We entertain
them. He dumps it off of the left flat. It's pulled in. A man falls down. And getting positive yardage to the 50 and a first down is Nate Washington.
Division title would come down to a matter of inches.
The receiver had 2 feet down in the end zone with possession of the ball and had a touchdown.
I'm talking about blocking. That's the way you play football, boy. I love you, boy. That's the way you play football.
Before they could celebrate a victory, the Steelers had to stop one last pass.
Throws it down the middle of the field, and it will be intercepted. Here comes William Gay. He's going to take the knee at the 10, and this baby is going, gone.
Big play, Willie Gay. Big play, Willie Gay.
Well, we got an excited football team in that room next door, and rightfully so. Ridiculously tough football game. Hopefully that's the signature Steeler football for 08. I know we've been in a bunch of these, and we found a way to see our way out of some of them. And boy, today was big.
What is Steelers football? That would be the question following Pittsburgh's game in Tennessee. Steelers scored 2 touchdowns through the air. But they struggled on the ground. They turned the ball over 4 times.
Ball coming with a rush. Hits him as he throws pass. Intercepted. Griffin. Touchdown, Titans! And there
Titans won the game and challenged the Steelers' toughness. Despite the loss, Pittsburgh had clinched the AFC's number two seed. Still, they had some unfinished business before beginning the playoffs. In their final regular season game, the Steelers set out to reestablish their blue-collar identity.
Parker is through a hole. He's on his way. 20, 15, 10. Parker gets to the pylon. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Willie Parker, a 34-yard run. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is his longest of the season.
Willie Parker, who had been slowed all season by knee and shoulder injuries, ran 23 times for 116 yards. In the second quarter, the Steelers got a scare when Roethlisberger went down with an apparent head injury. Roethlisberger turned out to be fine.
Yo, this is personal, man. Let's go get this right now.
And the Steelers rallied in his absence.
He's going to get out of there. He's got an ability to run. He cuts it inside the five. Touchdown, Byron Leftwich. And it was a work of art.
A work of art. It was like your kindergartner's first day in art class.
You see him almost fall, though? You see him trip over nothing? That was ugly.
Hey, I don't care how ugly it is. It's still six.
Hey, man, that was the ugliest one in NFL history, man.
Hey, why they was going all that way? I know the game, man.
I wasn't going over here. 90.
How many plays you make today? How many plays you make today? 91 talks so much. Oh, my God. He's like, you guys are sorry you gave up 49 sacks. I'm like, you can have all the sacks you want. We'll take 12 wins. Y'all going to lose in the first round of the playoffs anyways. All right, man. Go home, all right? You're done.
How long you done had 11 sacks, dog? You ain't had a sack in how long? You don't want to be great, though. You want to be good. You want to be great? You want to be great? Yeah, you don't like that.
The Steelers' defense showed they are more than just good. They are indeed great. They finished the year first in yards allowed, points allowed, passing yards allowed, and second against the run. In the season finale, they scored a touchdown and posted a shutout.
Those guys in that room know that great defenses, legendary defenses, make their mark in January football. From that standpoint, that's what we're excited about. We're not looking at the historical significance of what we got going on right now. We don't live in that world. We can't.
Everyone, welcome aboard the Duchess for shuttle service to Heinz Field. Our last shuttle will depart 60 minutes after the Steelers defeat the Chargers. Thank you.
Here we go, Steelers! Here we go! Here we go, Steelers! Here we go!
60 minutes! Everything you get! Hey! 60 minutes!
Pittsburgh nothing.
Just keep the troops cool. Hey, we discounted it, but we ain't panicking either. That's it.
Down by seven, the Steelers got the big play they needed.
Santonio Holmes floats back and takes it his own. 32. Runs to the middle. 35-40. 45-50.
Santonio Holmes began one of the great postseason performances in league history with a punt return for the ages.
Touchdown, into the end zone with a Pittsburgh touchdown. Santonio Holmes, he takes it 68 yards.
beauty out of it.
That's what I'm talking about. Get ready to go again. We might need another one.
That's what I'm talking about.
After allowing an opening drive touchdown, the defense clamped down.
Good job. Hey, that was a good job pushing the pocket. We pushed the pocket. He can't step up.
Let's answer the bell. Hustle back to the huddle, up to the line.
The offense, which had not scored a touchdown against the Chargers in eight quarters, began moving at will.
54 seconds left. Ben pumps, throws it. Bass is caught inside the 15, inside the 10 is Hines. The Steelers are entering the Hines red zone. To the left, running with the football. Parker's in the end zone, and the Steelers forge ahead.
Back up.
In the third quarter, the blue-collar Steelers were at their grind-it-out best.
Up, takes it on the 15, left numbers, finds a crack, up over the 20, 25, 30, 35, oh, still on his feet at the 40, cross midfield at the 50, still on his feet at the 45, 40, he's at the 35, 30, and run out of bounds on the far sideline, and that is not good.
The Chargers' offensive possession lasted one play.
Ball batted in the air.
The interception would be the Chargers' only play for the entire quarter.
Sproles comes up, going to let it hit. It hits. And San Diego turns it. Steelers pick it up.
Oh, my goodness. It hit Eric Weddle right in the head.
Hines Ward shakes the defender. First down as he grinds to the 10-yard line. And now we got a late flag, two late flags.
Charge.
You flopping like an old Boston Celtic. You like Danny Ainge.
That's that blotted
D-line.
Hands the ball off and running for the goal line. And getting to the goal line is Gary Russell.
Don't let it get away from us.
Yes, sir.
Hey, don't let the smash mouth football get away from us, man. We converted some third downs. Nice. Let's keep pounding, okay? Talk to your troops, all right?
In the fourth quarter, the Steelers' much-maligned offensive line was asked to finish the Chargers off. The unit responded with its finest performance of the season.
Hey, come on, pound this thing now. Pound this damn thing.
And all you can do, if you're Phillip Rivers and the San Diego offense, is watch, and you just see the sands slipping through the hourglass.
Willie Parker finished with a season-best 146 yards and put the game out of reach with his second touchdown.
He's going for the pylon. He's going for the 16-yard touchdown run.
Chargers are a tired football team right now, and they're a step slow. Their legs are dead.
Willie's first 100-yard postseason rushing game. Wow, what a performance by number 39.
You deserve it, man. Congratulations.
No, that's how you run the ball. That's what I'm talking about, baby. I like it.
Hey, good day's work. You know, it's funny. It's a coincidence, man. You're 100%
makes a difference. You know what I mean? You inspire that offensive line. You inspire the play caller. You got to keep that going, man.
Hey, you know, we got next week, baby.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Now only one team stood between the Steelers and Super Bowl 43.
Today you did it and did it big. Don't allow anybody to be more grounded than us, and we'll be a group that's ready to seize opportunity. Love this football team, man.
We're a band of brothers. Nothing can come between us.
Highlights of people hit. He was running full speed and Brian was coming downhill though.
They're just trying to walk up on all our skill guys saying they're gonna press you, they're gonna jam you, and you can't win. All right, that's bottom line what they're saying.
With a spot in the Super Bowl at stake, the Steelers showed their bitter rivals they were willing to fight for every inch.
Steelers show Flacco's gonna be stacked up.
Did he get there? The spot is everything and it doesn't look favorable.
Defense right there.
He's back. He looks. He gets pressure. He throws a pass. Intercepted. And the Steelers defense asserts itself.
Rookie mistake.
That's a good job. Continue to push the pocket. We'll be okay. That's a good job, man. Good job.
All right.
Hines Ward jump-starting the Steelers offense.
The pass is caught.
With Ward out, Santonio Holmes took over.
Throws it down the middle, and the pass is caught. He's down at the one. Santonio Holmes caught it, and it fell at the one.
I think that was a touchdown, Bill. I think I would challenge that. I really think that was a touchdown.
The pass was ruled incomplete, much to the Steelers' disbelief. Two possessions later, Holmes would take the matter of reaching the end zone into his own hands.
And it's caught by Santonio. Defender down. Cuts to the middle of the field. Gets by another defender. Picks up a block at the 30. Santonio, 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, Pittsburgh.
Play.
How about the football instincts of Santonio to cut it back to the middle of the field?
Absolutely.
Santonio went to the middle of the field from the right and then from the middle to the left and scored inside the pylon. And this place is crazy.
13:58 to play, first half, and the Ravens are in a hole. Steelers lead it 13-0.
I'm going to say this very calm. Every time you take your best freaking middle linebacker out of the middle, where do they go? Pittsburgh do this all the time. I've been playing them for 13 years. When you avoid the middle, they go into the middle. It's never changed.
Ahead 13-0, the Steelers gave the Ravens an opening.
Uh-oh, finds a crack. He's at the 50, the 40, the 35, the 30, the 25, and he's down. Look out, here comes Baltimore. And the pass is going to be broken up at the goal line.
And it's going to be pass interference on Pittsburgh.
Turns and hands it off. And running to the end zone is Willis McGahee for the Baltimore touchdown.
That's a huge touchdown for the Ravens.
Hey, we're in good
good shape. We're in good shape. Let's go to work. Let's go to work. We're in good shape. Let's go, baby. Let's go.
Hey, I might be out now. You got to go. I'm out, all right? Just play. Don't worry about nothing. Just play, okay?
There's a man wide open, Limus. He grabs the ball at the 8-yard line. Swede had four steps on the defender, and he just didn't hold the ball.
Hey, Swede! Swede! Hey, come here! Come here! Come here! Come here! Hey! Now you get that drop out your mind. Play ball, all right? You ready now? Let's go.
He good now. He ready. He good. He good now. Make a play right here, Sweet.
Four plays after the drop, Limus Sweet would make a play that would make Hines Ward proud. Ahead 16-7, the Steelers gave the Ravens another break.
Steelers bring blitz. Ravens pick it up. Flacco going
he's
in.
Got him.
It's in.
That's a penalty. First and goal, Baltimore at the Pittsburgh 1.
McGay, he gets the handoff. Right side. Shed the tackle and walks in for a touchdown. And with 9:29 to play in the ball game, it's the Steelers 16, the Ravens 14.
They needed to bury us, and they didn't.
They left us around again.
Don't mean no difference about nothing. We're up 2 points. We're going to get some more points, finish this game. They don't get nothing, we win. Let's go.
Joe Flacco becomes the starter thing. And you know why? Because defense stood up. That's who wins championships.
Defense does win championships. And with the season on the line, it wasn't the Ravens' defense, but the league's best that made the play to win the game.
Turn over time, man. Turn over time. Let's go.
The clock at 4:43 and winding. Flacco in the gun. He's back. He waits. He throws the pass, and it's intercepted.
Great teams make big plays at big moments. The Steelers had done it all year. And thanks to Troy Polamalu, they had done it again.
Good job. Good luck, man.
Y'all a hell of a football team. Y'all bring the best out in us. Great. I love these matchups, man.
Thank you. I love them too, Coach. Man. Good luck down there, right?
Thank you, man.
All right. The Pittsburgh Steelers win the AFC title game right here at Heinz Field, and this crowd has loved every single moment.
In Pittsburgh, the names and faces change, but the championship tradition lives on. In just his second year, Mike Tomlin had the Steelers one win away from Super Bowl title number 6.
Raymond James Stadium, the site of Super Bowl 43.
And this is it, the biggest game in sports, as the Cardinals take on one of the most successful franchises in the history of the National Football League.
Steelers, we back again. Ain't no pressure on us. We've been here, done that.
That's what we worked hard for, to get back to the Super Bowl. See if we can win our second Super Bowl in 4 years.
regular ball game. I know it's going to be hard, but trust me, take it from me. I didn't do it, you know?
Yep.
You don't have to do anything other than just be yourself.
For sure.
There is a quiet confidence. They are not awed by being here, and focus, intense focus.
Cards and Steelers, we are just moments away from kickoff.
It's a wrap, we're here now.
Here's the run up, and Super Bowl 43 is underway with the flag, folks, a popping.
It did not take long for Ben Roethlisberger and the Steelers to turn it on and light up the Cardinals.
Back is Ben, throws a pass down the field wide open. That is Hines Ward to the 50, the 40, first down to the 35, and he's knocked out of bounds on the far sideline.
Come on, throw this poke up. Right there. Big man.
Wants to throw. Pressure throws it down the field. That's Heath Miller inside the 5, and he's tackled at about the 1 foot line. Play action fake. Man rolls to the right. Pumps. He's going to run. He gets down to the goal line. And that is going to be a touchdown for Pittsburgh.
You look like Tim Tebow.
Arizona is challenged that the runner was down prior to crossing the goal line.
Brace yourself. Brace yourself.
Four.
If you guys take this touchdown off the board.
Oh, don't yell at me, okay?
I can't promise you that.
I don't yell.
The runner was down short of the goal line.
Mike Tomlin settled for the field goal, and for the first quarter and a half, his defense did not budge.
Coming into this game, Larry Fitzgerald was storyline A. He has one catch for 12 yards.
No matter how they shuffled the deck, the Cards could not play a winning hand. Pittsburgh's quarterback always had something up his sleeve. And play after play, he trumped whatever Arizona threw at him.
Ben scrambles out of the pocket left, now goes back to the right. Needs a block, spun around, throws the pass down the field. It is caught! He barely grabbed, first down to the 22-yard line.
Man, you talk about abracadabra disappearing. A bunch of guys had a shot at Ben. He spins out, scrambles back against the grain.
In his second Super Bowl, it was Ben there. Done that for Roethlisberger. And he dismantled the Cardinals on an 11-play, 7-minute marathon of a drive.
Let's get this thing in the end zone. How about that? That'd be good. Let's get this thing in the end zone.
Plowing in for a Steelers touchdown is Gary Russell.
Way to start out the Super Bowl, baby.
Clap pressure, baby. Clap pressure. Gotta keep it clap pressure, Aaron.
We keep busting three and out, then it's gonna crack.
Give it one great play at a time. All right? One great play at a time. Keep working. Our offense is going to do something here now.
Time of possession a factor so far. The Steelers with roughly 12 and a half minutes to the Cardinals 3.5.
They've only run five plays in the first 15 minutes. These guys in red on offense got to be stiff.
Arizona had 1 foot in the grave, but as long as there's a pulse, Kurt Warner and the Cardinals are dangerous. And in the second quarter, they came roaring back to life.
How unbelievable is this football team back from the dead? Cardinals got to get it in. Warner stumbles, but now regains his balance, throws left into the end zone, and it is caught! Touchdown! What a grab by Ben Patrick!
An 83-yard drive in 9 plays. They never got to a third down.
And the Cardinals are alive! Kurt Warner somehow got enough sauce on the pig to get it over the head of the defender.
That's what we're all about, responding in that situation. That's a good job.
Don't blink.
With 18 seconds left in the half, the Cardinals were 1 yard away from taking the lead.
18 seconds left of the second quarter here at Super Bowl 43. First and goal, Arizona. They trail by 3.
All season long, the Steelers had won with defense.
Come on, D!
They come up short. They're going to be too close to the ball in the end zone. This is a throw into the end zone.
In the biggest test of their biggest game, linebacker James Harrison baited Kurt Warner into a cardinal sin.
Steelers show blitz. He throws the pass up. It's going to be picked off. James Harrison has it. He's running up the sideline.
It was a 14-point swing. It was the longest play in Super Bowl history. It was miraculous to a franchise that knows something about football miracles. And in Pittsburgh, it will always be known as the Immaculate Interception. Defensive player of the year had taken everyone's breath away. The Steelers were now just 30 minutes away from their sixth world championship. The stage was set for one of the most dramatic halves in Super Bowl history.
That'd be great.
Got you.
Hey, that'd be great, man. Let's go down to history right now, man. Let's finish it out, baby. Let's go.
Steelers scored the only 3 points of the third quarter and led 20-7.
Hey, great job, D! Good job, D! Who wanted more? Who wanted more? That's when it counts! That's when it counts!
The highest scoring team in the postseason had been held down by the NFL's number one defense. But in the furious 5-minute stretch in the fourth quarter, Larry Fitzgerald and the Cardinals erupted.
Side Fitzgerald, he got it! Touchdown!
Touchdown!
Steeler Nation was squirming. Even more so when Pittsburgh was pinned back at its own 1-yard line. A holding call in the end zone gave Arizona safety and the ball back. The Steelers' lead was down to 4.
Time fires over the middle of the fence. Caught at the 45, 50. Fence is loose. 40, 30. Goodbye. Cardinals lead. Touchdown. Larry Fitzgerald.
Many teams would fold and fail under such adversity. The Steelers aren't just any team.
Love,
78 yards is a long way to go, especially on the game's greatest stage with a world championship on the line.
Hey, 10,
I want the ball rolling.
Hey, I want the ball.
Gets the snap. He's back. He waits. He escapes. Starts running to his right. Throws it on the run. The pass is caught. Holmes gets to the 27. McMahon is going to step up in the pocket and fire the pass complete to Santonio Holmes with a great catch in traffic up at the 39-yard line.
Come on, we're killing time.
Man, just the, my stomach's in knots.
Gets the snap. Pumps, fires a pass, it's caught. Running down the sideline, 30, 25, Santonio to the 10. Santonio tackle at the 5-yard line with 51 seconds now, 50 to go.
With 48 seconds left, what could have been a game-winning touchdown pass sailed through the outstretched arms of Santonio Holmes. Pittsburgh trailed by 3. 42 seconds remain.
We need this play, man. Just win the championship for us right here, man.
Second and goal at the 7. Ben gets the snap. He's back. He pumps. He scrambles around, throws it back corner of the end zone. Santonio with a touchdown! Santonio Holmes! I don't know how he did it, but they rule touchdown in the far right corner of the end zone. It's unbelievable what this team has done to put themselves in this position.
And actually, Ben was looking at Hines initially, then he looks for Santonio in the corner, and Santonio goes up, comes down with his feet down in the corner. What a throw, what a catch. What a game!
What a play by Santonio.
Every time this team needed to make a play this year, they came up with a big play. What a finish to an unbelievable Super Bowl.
One of the greatest catches ever had the Steelers on the brink of greatness. But they weren't there quite yet.
Time unprecedented in the annals of NFL play.
Oh my goodness, man, we did it, baby. We did it. We did it. We worked hard for this. We did it.
You're a champion. Champion, baby.
The final score of Super Bowl 43, the Pittsburgh Steelers 27, the Arizona Cardinals 23.
Great teams make big plays at big moments. The Steelers had done it all year. And in the year's biggest game, they did it again. Now six-time Super Bowl champions, the Pittsburgh Steelers stand alone atop the football world.